Let's take a look at one of the two plugins that comes with the Clasp hardware. This plugin is called the Clasp Bridge plugin. You're going to only use one instance of this per session. You can insert this on any channel within the session. First thing we're going to look at with this plugin is the countdown timer. Countdown timer indicates how much time in minutes and seconds is left on the tape reel. This also corresponds with the countdown timer on the front panel of the Clasp hardware. Next, we have the IPS indicator. This indicates what tape speed the Clasp hardware is set to, 15 IPS, 7.5 IPS, and 30 IPS. As you'll notice, changing the IPS setting also updates the timer. Next, we have the post-roll indicator. This post-roll indicator tells us what the post-roll setting is on the Clasp hardware, off, 6 seconds, and 12 seconds. Next is the monitor indicator. This indicates what monitor mode the Clasp hardware is in, channels 1 through 24, channels 1 through 16, and repro. Next, we have the offset indicator. Offset is used to fine-tune for the latency introduced by your A-D converters. If you know the latency of your A-D converter, you can enter it by clicking on this area and typing it in. Here we have the tape machine name area. Currently it says not synchronized. If it were synchronized, it would say the name of the tape machine that has been synchronized with the Clasp hardware. Underneath, we have the sync indicator. When the sync indicator is red, it tells us that the Clasp hardware is not synchronized at all. If it were green, that would indicate that it has been properly synchronized, and you would see a value here other than zero. Over here, we have the sample rate that's been selected within the session that Clasp is running. Here we have the track arming window. This area indicates which tracks are armed within the Clasp hardware. One thing to note, since Clasp with Pro Tools uses Huey to control transport and track arming, Huey depends upon banks of 8 channels. So for example, if you want to see what's happening in Pro Tools as far as track arming on tracks 9 through 16, you can use the bank arrows here to bank back and forth, or you can click directly on the row of tracks. So if I'm arming tracks in Pro Tools, this is what it looks like. You'll see that the tracks on the selected bank are showing up immediately, but tracks that are outside of the selected bank are not showing up. Clicking on the update button is a fast, easy way to make sure that all the tracks are armed properly within the Clasp hardware. It'll cycle through all the banks for you and automatically arm and disarm tracks within the Clasp hardware, turning yellow when it's finished. The next button we're going to talk about is the power button. The power button takes the tape machine on and offline. So for example, right now the button's blue, the tape is online. If I were to hit play in Pro Tools with tracks armed, it's going to say tape rolling. You got this green indicator to let us know that the tape's rolling, and the countdown timer is counting backwards. If I were to take the power button and turn it off, now the tape's offline. If I hit play, the tape does not roll. This is really useful for saving wear and tear on your tape deck, saving your tape. For example, let's say you're just doing some editing, you don't want to have the tape running, but you want to leave your tracks armed, you can just take your tape offline. Just be sure to put the tape back online before you start recording again, otherwise you're going to record silence. One way to know is you're going to see this red indicator here. You hit play, you're not going to see the green tape reel indicator letting you know the tape is rolling. Put the tape back online. Now tape's rolling. Punching in on Pro Tools, you'll see that the tape indicator turns red to let you know you've punched in to record. Stopping the transport, the tape indicator will turn white. The next button I want to show you is input. This allows you to go into input monitoring prior to punching in to record. So for example, let's say you're recording a vocalist and they want to hear themselves drop into input early. You can just press this button. They can hear themselves, then you can punch in. The next button over here is the repro button. This allows you to audition the sound of analog tape while you're recording. So for example, you're recording an instrument or a drum kit. You want to know what the tape is actually sounding like, how the tape's reacting to the level, the EQ, the compression, what's going on to the tape. You can put it in record, press the repro button, so you can decide which tape speed or which EQ or compression levels you want to put down to tape. So that way you can get the best result possible. Clicking it again takes it out of repro, puts it back into input monitoring. The next button is the return to zero button. It's really simple, you just click it. It rewinds the tape deck back to the beginning for you. Next, we have the mode button, which we've already talked about showing us tape rolling and showing us punch in, record. This also changes the mode of the Clasp plugin. We have three basic modes. The first one is tape mode, which is indicated by a tape reel here, and also text down here in the bottom corner of the Clasp plugin. If you want to switch to a different mode, just simply click on the button. The next mode that comes up is direct mode. Direct mode allows you to record through the tape machine when it's an input, not recording onto tape, but just through the tape machine, or even around the tape machine, without timestamping the audio at all. So, for example, let's say you'd recorded something into Pro Tools through Clasp, through tape, and you decided that you wanted to do a bounce, but you didn't want to bounce through tape again. You could patch around or just put your tape machine in input, drop the Clasp plugin into direct mode, do your pass, do your punch. When you drop into direct mode, it automatically takes the tape offline for you. The next mode here is programmer mode. This mode is used when you're recording with a virtual instrument inside of Pro Tools. So for example, you've got a synthesizer or a virtual drum machine and you want to lay down a MIDI track. You'll need to put Clasp in this mode so you'll have low latency monitoring while you're recording a MIDI instrument. Once you finish recording your MIDI instrument, you can take the Clasp plugin back into tape mode, and you can even repatch the output of that virtual instrument from Pro Tools into the Clasp inputs and re-record it through tape so you can get that analog sound on your virtual instruments printed to tracks within the Pro Tools session, all sample accurate in real time. Next is Audible Rewind. Audible Rewind is a feature that allows you to hear the sound of the tape deck rewinding. Default setting is off. If you want to turn it on, just click this little button. It's kind of cool for some people. They love to hear the sound of the tape rewinding. Next is the machine selector. This is a drop-down menu. You can select which tape machine you're on. So for example, let's say we roll some tape here. We're on machine one. We've got 14 minutes and 54 seconds left on machine one. Let's say we've got a second tape machine that we've synchronized with Clasp that we want to do overdubs with. So we could select machine two. Selecting machine two, the Clasp is going to automatically update to whatever machine two settings were. So as you can see, the Clasp will store and sync up to three decks, and you can run up to three Clasp systems all together at the same time. Next is a MIDI port drop-down menu. This is where you set up your MIDI in and MIDI output ports. This is pretty critical. In this session, you'll see I've got the Clasp set to MIDI port B. The last button I want to show you here is if you click on Bank, it'll arm every track that can possibly be armed in the Pro Tools session, as well as all the Clasp tracks. So if you click it again, all Clasp tracks disarmed and all Pro Tools tracks disarmed. The second plugin in the Clasp software suite is the Clasp Machine Sync plugin. This plugin is to be used on mono master faders within a Pro Tools session or on mono input faders on a Nuendo or Cubase session. Over here, you'll notice this is the indicator area to tell you the name of the tape machine and synchronization values. Currently, this plugin is not synchronized. If it were, this would indicate the tape machine name, and this would indicate a green sync indicator along with a synchronization value. The green tape reel indicates that the plugin is running in tape sync mode. If you wished to record some tape tracks and some direct digital tracks, you would turn the plugin off into direct mode on the tracks that are direct digital tracks. Any tracks that are tape tracks, of course, this will be turned on and be green.